Yes, correct. First of all, welcome in Rome, but welcome at the Savoy Hotel also. I hope you can appreciate the hotel, the services, and also my staff. Yes. Now, I received a message from Ms. Susan Sari, the director of Young School International. Now, I will reread the message she sent to me. Dear young colleague and those young attending at the symposium, greetings from my office at the Turku University of Applied Sciences. Next to me is a file of excellence to be marked and on my screen, a lecture for tomorrow about service concepts hotels. I feel sad that my work duties had to come first this time. But while dreaming, do remember to raise a school toast to happiness, good health, long life, and friendship. Looking forward to see you all soon. Susan Sari, director of the Young School. Today, we will talk about mentoring. Now, I will introduce our Rome president, Mr. Augusto Minelli.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for being here today, so numerous. Before starting the panel, of which I'm the coordinator, the mentoring, I'd like to say just a couple of things which were not said yesterday when we had the switch of the computer. First of all, I'd like to show you the splendid video, the promotional video of Call International. It's a new video, it's just a 2 minutes video, but it's really a fantastic one. We want to show, especially for the people who have not yet seen it.
Probably is not enough to build up long life business. We need to bring, I think, in our daily business, other patients we have. And each of us can become, with years of experience, a real masterpiece. With different passions. Everyone can show different side of characters, of wishing, of dreams, and so on.
First of all, let me say, we talk about mentoring. We can have a day talking about mentoring by itself. But the idea that I have is to talk about mentoring connected with the young school, not mentoring in general. What is mentoring? Mentoring is the transmission, I'm reading what is written on the dictionary, is the transmission of knowledge from one generation to another. It's the added value and is commonly referred to mentoring. The personal name mentor has been adopted in English and in all the language as a term meaning someone who imparts wisdom and shares knowledge with a less experienced colleague or young person. So this is a general. Then there are various differences in coaching, training, sponsoring, and mentoring.
I want to know, in your opinion, how can we match your mentoring experience with our easy approach in using new technologies and social network?
Ask the name is a little question.
I will answer in about 2 hours. In 2 hours, I will answer to your question.
But practically, we really want to know what you can offer in practical terms to us, because you really, you know well the situation in Italy, and if you compare a young German or French person, it's not the same. You know, the surroundings is not the same. So what you can offer in practical terms, not in theory, to a young person.
Yes, yes, thank you. Sorry, former President Boris Lantas from Turkey.
Talking about mentoring in general, you just said experience. I think what we have seniors is the experience, and we have paid for it over years, over time.
A high price.
Means high prices. We have made mistakes. We learn from our mistakes, and this is what makes us come to the stage of mature or whatever you call it.
A special applause to Christina because she's the coordinator of this symposium. Thank you, Christina.
In your opinion, we could really speak about mentoring in Italy?
This is a great question. Now we have Giorgio Preti. Probably the next, that's our general manager.
So we are young and we have to improve this association. So I would like to know, in your opinion, what have been the errors that you made in the past, in your opinion, inside the association, so SCAL association.
For young?
No, in generally speaking.
And the transaction in that, as you know, we have a job bank in our website. So that's another problem which I would ask from the younger generation, especially more, because with older generation we have that lack. We are, or the executive of the Scholar International and the council as well, sometimes working very hard on achieving certain things, and they are on our website. But we are seeing that our website is not being visited enough. So we are hearing sometimes things as a proposal which are already there. So especially for younger people, from mentoring, I have to come to that as well, we have a document in there which says FLP. Have you ever seen that? Did anybody know about it?
NLP?
FLP.
FLP.
Future Leaders Program.
Future Leaders Program. Just enter it and revise it. You will see that there is a good lead for mentoring our generations or our next generations. Okay. Thank you very much.
Another question from Mr. Corallini. He works in the account department of our hotel.
Yeah. I want to ask if it's more important for you in mentoring to transfer to your generation the strategy of the work, the goals or the strategy, or exactly what is the work? Because in my opinion, in 20 years, the work, exactly the work, will change.
You mentioned a specific item, if you want a goal or anything, but for your information, mentoring is covering a lot of things. Just to say some. You can gain valuable advice. We can develop, with our experience, not a technical experience, we can develop knowledge and skills. We can improve your communication skills. That's what you were mentioning. You can learn new perspectives by our experience and mentoring. You can build your network, your contacts. We have the contacts. We can transfer these contacts to you so you can build your own contacts, and we can help you in advancing in your career, giving suggestions, whatever would be helpful to you. So not a specific item, but a global package. So mentoring is giving you a global package. Sorry. the needs of the young members.
The special all-inclusive.
When you were talking about actually setting the goals, we cannot set the goals for you. You have to set, everybody has to set its goal himself. And then, of course, when you see that you are not reaching, I mean, we are not teachers. You have to go forward. But then there might come a moment when you don't really know which way should I go. That's where you need the mentor.
That's what I was asking to you all. Yeah. If you get enter the website and click on the membership development FLP, you will see quite a good guidelines. You can add to that. You can, of course, and come back and mentor us in forming it in better. My sound is enough, I suppose. Yeah. But so you have to have that curiosity to get into our website and to search in there as well.
But no one actually has, because I was thinking maybe that you could have a document, maybe a few items on this document, so all the clubs have the same
thing
that you can follow, yeah. I know the fact that not all clubs run the same way, so I just present my club and how we found a pretty good solution for this problem. First of all, we have two clubs, okay? The senior club and the young club, who work independently. They have their own board and their own meetings. We have our own board and our own meetings. They also have their own projects. We have our own projects. But we work as one entity. Sorry, the president of the Roman club, that we say, okay, I am available to help you. I have this time. I think this is a great idea.
First of all, we have the same structure in Turkey, like a Bucharest club. We try to meet separately and we try to share something with the youngs. But it is important to get the same meetings with the senior school because they are the mentor. We get something for them. That's the one thing. That's
in their wish.
Yes, in their wish.
Well, thank you all for taking my question today and having us all here. I wanted to know, I when you said the develop this one mentor program like we've been discussing, I kind of want to know if you have any ideas or have worked on this mentor program at all, and if you have any development going on for that program. And I also wanted to know, also wanted to say that with this program, I believe that it would help keep us as young scholars accountable for actually using our mentorships and using the knowledge that we are gaining and using them in the field. And by doing this, you know, some ideas for doing this would be maybe creating events, like you said, like it's events, but even on a local level, creating events for a young scholar information we are gaining.
We are doing, especially in Rome, as you see, there are some clubs having a separation, clear separation between the senior club and the young club. Some of the club, they do all together. For instance, we have Mr. Roberto Necci, who is a member of our board. At the same time, he's the responsible for the young section. We don't make a separation. We do all together. So when we have a board meeting, just for your information, before we have other program, and he's representing the young, and then he reports to the young. And when we make an event, we are all together. Our circular does not go only to the senior and separate to the young. Our main...
She works as a reception in a boutique hotel in close to... Laura Square.
Ah. Thank you.
A good interview.
Thank you. So, we have been talking about and discussing about mentors and mentoring and their special relationship, okay? And what I would like to ask you is, in your personal opinion, if you could give an advice to the young, what would it be?
My name is Jenny. I'm from Istanbul School International. And I'm not here
Hi. I have two comments, question points on mentoring. One, I think, in Nairobi, I come from Skal, Kenya, Nairobi. We are as many as one. I'm the only young Skal member. We have had a few young Skal members before, but they lose interest. Yes, why? Because you come, you attend one, two Skal meetings, and I think as young people, we want to be interested. We want a reason to do what we are doing. I come to Skal to get the connection, the networking, to help me in my career, making decisions in life and all that, yeah? But then I think that for Skal Kenya Nairobi, for young Skal to grow, we need, other than mentorship, we need, the senior Skal needs to give us a go ahead, yeah?
My question is, you know, all of you are obviously well experienced within the industry. What tools or what, you know, you obviously had a vision or goals within your respective career. What tools did you use to build that vision and goals? And the second part of my question is, what vision and goals are we setting for Young Skal? And what is Young Skal going to look like in 5 years, 10 years, and 15 years?
Interesting question. Bravo, Presidente, bravo.
Now, as a professional, actually, I'm a hotelier. What I can advise, of course, is a good education to begin with. And then, before entering into real life of work, during your training periods, and also at the initial parts of your, if you are training for hotelier, I'm talking about, so with tour operators and agencies, I cannot say much. But in the sense of hotels, the most important thing you need is that first, I ask, for example, I am giving sometimes lectures in the Mediterranean University as well. I ask to the young people, I say, you have to have two virtues. If you don't have those, please don't get into the industry. You might fail at one point and you cannot go further. And they are curious and they ask, what is it? And I say, first, you have to have a sociable character and you should love people. If you are an introvert character and you don't like socializing and you don't really care that much about other people, but only yourself or perhaps your family, then tourism is not a good profession for you. The second, I say, is patience. If you don't have patience in tourism, you are done for.
Attention, the last but not the least, Antonio. I am Councillor of Italy and also I am worker of this symposium. And then I am also Secretary of Rome. First of all, thanks for your cooperation. People need people. And without your cooperation, there isn't the success of this symposium.
For being here with us. And mainly, I would like to thank you for making this room a living room. So don't be afraid, don't be scared, do questions, and making this happening alive and happening. This is important. My name is Raffaele, and I've been working for Rome Airport, the company that managed the airport in Rome. So Fiumicino and Ciampino, we have two airports here, and we manage 40 million per year. 40 million passengers per year, and we are number 6 in Europe. Just to say,
target 100 million.
Targeting 100 million in 30 years time from now. I'm in charge for the route development, so I'm in charge for attracting new business in Rome. Specifically, I'm now looking for the Asian side of the world. So, for example, tomorrow I'm leaving for China. And I will meet airlines, I will meet tour operators, I will meet travel agency. In trying to convince them that Rome could be an interesting spot in Europe.
The program, because we don't see the website. we wait, or not. That's the problem. And
So for me, it was an honor to be inducted as a young skull in Orlando. And it's a just very, very small example, and I'm very, very thankful to all the presidents and to Antonio, of course, who kind of hosted me as a family here in Italy, because SCAL is really a family, and I want to be just a witness of what that can mean to be a young SCAL internationally, because you can just move around the world and always have a family that can host you, like you were mentioning before. So I just went there, and then I started working as a cast member at Disney, and President were mentioning earlier that, first of all, before managing any department, you really need, in the hospitality industry, how to be at the reception, how to be serving somebody in a restaurant, how to get a tip.
This is terrible for new generations, because even when we were beginning 20 or 30 years ago, our business was not easy if you were a first generation employer. But everyone was saying to you, go on, and in a few months, in a few years, in 2 decades, you will become strong. The future is good. Now the common mentality is to be pessimistic, to say tomorrow is worse than now.
Imagine that.
Thank you.
So I think you have all enjoyed your meals, and you are at the end of it with the treats. I just wanted to start the formalities because I want to present to Augusto a small token of my appreciation and some of my banners to Antonio and Roberto as well. And then I think Ankara has something, Julia has something. So you shall complete the night like that, if you allow me.
Momento.
This is a special token from Turkey. That's a special edition.
Why those things open? That have it that far away.
This is really a fantastic gift I like you to see. We've been living in Turkey for about 6 years, so I know exactly the value and the meaning of such a masterpiece, because this is the most important and major factory in Turkey doing this precious gift. And I'm very grateful to President Salih and to my colleagues.
Give my banners as
well. With the president. So this we call people to
please give this to Germano. And Roberto.
A me, Tonio.
So this comes from Ankara. We heard of Anatolia.
This comes from Ankara, and this is really a masterpiece. I'm really grateful because it's fantastic. We heard of Anatolia. So, President of Maka, Sadiq Bey,
Gira.
Thank you very much. Of course, I accept as President of Skoll International Rome, but everybody, all the members of Skoll International Rome, are grateful to you and grateful to President Sadiq Bey. We are really all with you, all with you. We are proud of them. Oh,
with great pleasure. We are very honored to have a president with us. We are very proud to have a president with AXA Luce. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.